Okay.
I'm in.
So we get to start from this point then.
All right, fine. All right, we fixed it. Temporary insanity.
We're getting coins so we can take Funky's flight to the new B level.
Yeah, Nicolas Cage's favorite world.
I knew we were going to bring that up again. Oh, that was Trixie.
Yeah, I just had to warm up.
Anyways, Winnie the Pooh.
Why the hell do you want to talk about Winnie the Pooh? That is so random.
I would have told you. I was driving to Reading, and I thought, wait, how big is the 100-acre forest?
100 acres?
But, how, like, in real numerology. Like,
like how many miles is it an acre?
Yeah, or how many feet. So I looked it up. Not small, but it's not big.
All right.
Okay.
It just sounds big because it's got the word 100 next to it?
Yes.
All right.
And then... who the fuck is Christopher Robin? Does he just live, like, at the edge of the forest?
Well, you never see his parents.
No. Does he have parents? Is he an orphan? Is he a ghost?
Well, are his stuffed animals his imagination?
And another thing. Winnie the Pooh's stuffed with fluff, right?
Yeah, that's what stuffed animals...
Why the fuck is he eating honey? He has no digestive system.
I think you're thinking too into a kid's book. Slash Disney cartoon. Slash everything.
I told you. It was like 5 in the morning... I was driving to Reading. I didn't want to do it.
5 in the morning?
Yes.
Wow.
I left at 5 in the morning.
Your brain patterns at 5 in the morning took you to a very strange place. You're okay. A stuffed animal eating honey. Where does it go?
He can't shit it out.
And that means he's a sticky bear. Like the goo I'm standing
you're
in right now.
You're my sticky bear.
I mean, Christopher Robin has to pick up that sticky bear.
And are the kangaroos stuffed animals too?
I think every one of those animals are stuffed.
The owl's not.
Why not?
Because he can fly.
Well, yeah, but Winnie the Pooh can still technically move around and eat honey.
I don't think the owl is a stuffed animal. I'm pretty sure he's real.
I vaguely remember in the old 60s Winnie the Pooh cartoons, they had live-action intro that had all of them sitting on a shelf.
Oh, I remember that. Do you remember I'm a Little Black Rain Cloud?
That sounds familiar.
Hovering over a honey tree.
Oh, okay. Okay, now, I'm surprised that you remember that, but then again, we all remember.
I only remember that because I had a computer game that pretty much had that whole Winnie the Pooh movie in it, the many images of Winnie the Pooh.
Okay, if we're going to be saying what we can remember, I remember the Heffalumps and Woozles song.
Oh, that was awesome. That was an acid trip.
Yeah, that was probably one of my favorite Winnie the Pooh
And then
cartoons.
It's also on the Disneyland ride.
Oh, yeah, it is. That is true. That is true. The Disneyland ride was cool. Very random. There was an episode of The Adventures of Winnie the Pooh where they had to go underneath Christopher Robin's bed and there was a mucky creature that looked like Jabba the Hutt.
What the fuck?
Yeah, and he had to fight salt crayons that were the soldiers. Kind of reminded me of Alice in Wonderland. It was the trippiest, one of the trippiest episodes of Winnie the Pooh I remember.
I think Winnie the Pooh in general is just an acid trip.
Yeah, it's old too, so they're dropping acid like a long time ago.
It wasn't originally a Disney property. Either.
No,
Disney bought the rights, I think.
Yeah, they did. It was done by the book was done by an author. Disney was buying up all sorts of stories back then. Whoa, that was a little too close. A little too close.
Yeah, my wife and I are going back to Disneyland for our 1 year anniversary.
When's that?
I died. I couldn't complete your jump. Anyways, that's in September.
That sounded very morbid. When's your anniversary? I died.
Gonna collect that sweet, sweet life insurance.
There you go. Well, at least your wife is taken care of.
This grapple juice is amazing.
That's what it's called? Grapple juice?
No, it's apple, organic apple grape. But
oh, you called it grapple.
Grapple is just fun.
You put a little play on words. You're a lyrical wordsmith.
I think grapple's an actual fruit, too.
Oh. Cross-contamination? I mean,
cross-contamination? This isn't meat and vegetables on a cutting board.
It could be. It's fruit mixing in with a salad.
You would get chopped for that. You ever watch Chopped?
I used to.
Oh, Chopped is amazing. I love Chopped. I love Chopped and Kitchen Nightmares.
I've seen Kitchen Nightmares.
Oh, man. He just yells at everybody and it makes me feel good about myself.
I don't really have cable, so I don't really watch
I don't
a
have
lot
cable either.
Stuff.
I have YouTube and piracy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the wonderful world of the internet where everything is at your disposal.
Everything is free on the internet.
Oh, I jumped too soon.
Just like everything's a dildo if you try hard enough.
Well, some things that are free do come with viruses and spam.
That's why you don't be stupid.
Yeah, I'm just saying, it's not all safe.
Fuck! It's not all safe!
Yeah, that was a virus right there next to spam. That's what we're gonna call those two.
Spams?
Yep.
What are the porcupines? Trojans.
There you go. Just don't... Yeah, I'm not gonna touch that one.
Trojan man. Oh. Wow, that was the worst jump you've ever done in your life.
Yeah.
You should probably fucking kill yourself.
I think I just did. Now you try it.
Do it again.
No, you do it.
Do it in real life.
No. I'd like to keep playing. I'd like to relive my failures in this game.
I don't know what to do. Nathan, look at Diddy. He doesn't know what to do either. He's like, oh, God.
Do you drop and go in the barrel?
Oh.
You did that on purpose.
No, I didn't. I could not have planned that. Every time you jump, she fucking eats the honey. She gets fat. Dude, he's not gonna love her anymore.
Oh, hey, I found the letter O. This is brought to you by the letter O. For, oh my god.
She's a cookie. That's good enough. I fucking love Cookie Monster. He's so awesome.
He doesn't eat cookies anymore, last I checked.
No, he does.
He does?
Yeah, he does.
I thought he was vegetables now.
No, that was a rumor.
Oh.
I think. I don't know. I don't fucking watch it.
You know, I don't watch Sesame Street either. You know they moved it to HBO, right?
Did they really?
Yeah, it's not on PBS anymore.
That seems kind of messed up.
Yeah. Things change. Times change. How do I get that?
You love Mr. Rogers, though. Mr. Rogers, please.
He was my neighbor.
Oh, I grew up watching Mr. Rogers.
Oh, shit.
That was before I turned into a shitty person.
Hey, woo! Ooh, I'm back.
I like we're just gonna ignore the fact that I'm a shitty person.
I hate doing that move with Diddy Kong. You do that one very well. So what makes you a shitty person?
Oh, just the fact that I exist and I do the things I do.
Oh, and Mr. Rogers cured all that?
No. That was me. I watched it before I was a shitty person.
Gotcha.
It did nothing to help me. Yeah. If I make those noises, it helps me jump better.
Yeah. Also sounds like you're constipated.
Yeah. Oh, that's the worst feeling in the world.
I wanted the letter G.
Last time I was constipated, I was walking around my bathroom fucking butt-ass naked, just rubbing my stomach, just praying I could shit.
That's pretty scary, actually.
Ooh, safe spot!
Do we have coins? We have one!
It's okay, first save free.
Oh, that's right. Alright, we're good. We don't have to relive that horror. You do realize that this is where we got stuck at when we were playing this before at your house. Do you think we could do better? Do you want to put money on it?
I don't have any money to bet.
I got a quarter.
I just got paid, and that means I have no money.
Adult life. Yeah, I can't be buying new games, and that's why I'm playing games like this right now.
All my expendable money went into No Man's Sky.
However, I am going to buy Final Fantasy 15 when it comes out at the end of September. Well, I do, so you get to see how awesome it is!
So I guess you could play that for me and I'll watch.
There you go. Hey, this game took 10 years to come out.
And then I'll criticize the fuck out of it and ruin it for everybody.
I don't know if I want you over, because I want to enjoy it.
Well, you'll enjoy it. And then I'll enjoy the crushing it. I played Final Fantasy X like halfway through and thought, this is fucking stupid, and I stopped playing it.
Oh, you missed on some good stuff, man. I didn't really enjoy 10.
I remember the stupid laugh and saying, ah, ha, 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 ha.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
God, that was cringy.
Well, you do realize that was the first time Final Fantasy did voice acting.
Did it really?
Yep.
Well, it was fucking terrible.
Well, when they came out with Final Fantasy XII, it was a big improvement.
Did I kill all the bees, or did I get to the end?
You kill all the bees. You do what Nicolas Cage couldn't.
You kill all the bees.
Not the bees!
Oh, shit.
Now fly.
Nope, not gonna make
fly,
it.
Fly.
You go now, Mr. Powers.
Ah!
Oh!
We were so close. You saw the coin forming through the clouds and the smoke.
Give me that O. I need an O-gasm.
Gig.
I love the faces they make. And jump. This carnival looks like a trip, though. looks better than the state fair.
Yeah, kind of does. Except you know what I got to do at the state fair? Catch Pokemon.
Pokemon goes.
Dude, they had Pokestops and lures and everything. It was great.
I haven't played in like 2 weeks.
I haven't played in about 2 or 3 days.
So is your addiction broken now or what?
Slightly. I mean, once they took away the tracking device, it makes it difficult. So
you're
I
fucking cheater.
Well, no, it was built into the game.
Oh, that's right, that thing.
Yeah.
I thought you meant like the tracking.
Websites. No, I don't use the websites, but it makes it tough because when you the whole three-step thing is like, hey, there's a Pokemon nearby, and if you know you can find it, it's great. But now I just turn it on to go, huh? I guess there could be Pokemon nearby, but do I really feel like
I got one now?
I don't want to wander. I don't want to wander. So these days, I'll just turn on just say there's Pokemon nearby. If not, I'll turn it off. And sometimes my wife and I will go out to the park and go buy a lure and hang out for a bit, but yeah.
I'm out of grapple juice. Hey guys, this is Brandon.
And this is Nathan.
Thanks for watching this Geek Pals video.
If you like what you saw, give us a like.
And don't forget to hit that subscribe button.
Stay tuned for more awesome videos.
And I can't believe you're making me say this, Nathan, but remember,
keep geeking.